This is Bishop George Murray. On behalf of your Catholic friends and neighbors in the Diocese of Youngstown, I invite you to join us for this celebration of the Holy Mass.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Paul's. Please join me in the opening song, number 223, We Three Kings. We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts. We traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright. Westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to the perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to the perfect light.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
We thank all of you who have braved the cold and come out to join us here at St. Paul Monastery. And we also welcome those who are joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Epiphany of the Lord. And so we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we come together in this Eucharist, let us pause and reflect upon our relationship with God and ask Him for His mercy, His love, and His forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah. All from Sheba shall come bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth. Son. With justice he'll govern your people, your afflicted ones with right judgment. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Justice shall lasting peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth will adore. Rescues the poor when they cry out, the afflicted with no one to help. The lowly and poor he shall pity, the lives of the poor he will save. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and to the prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh.
Alleluia.
Be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search diligently for the child, that I too may go and do him homage.' After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. And then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way." The Gospel of the Lord. Bless you. Today is the Feast of the Epiphany, which means you get to hear my annual story about my dad's nativity scene. But since I haven't been here in a while, it hasn't been annual for you for about 12 years. So the story is, in Louisville, Kentucky, there is the street that we lived on for many years. A lot of people decorated their houses. And so people would drive by to see the decorations in our neighborhood. And we as children always knew that people always slowed down in front of the houses. And one year there was a man who slowed down and stopped in front of our house, parked the car, came and knocked on the door. And my father opened the door and the guy says, "I have to admire all your decorations here, but I'm a little confused about your nativity scene." My dad says, "Well, what's the problem?" He says, "I noticed that the three wise men are dressed as firemen. They got the hat, they got the axes, they got the hoses, they got the boots, they got the whole regalia, and it's just confusing to me why they are dressed like that." And my dad said, "Oh, it's very simple. Remember, they're dressed as firemen because in the scriptures it said they came from afar." And that's the reaction I usually get. So next year, you're going to hear it again, and you'll give me the same reaction. There is the author, Charles Dickens, who writes better stories than my story about my father, wrote one time a story of the tale of two cities. And today I'm going to tell you the tale of three cities. The first city is an unnamed city from where the wise men came from. Now, there are speculations in all the various stories whether they all came from the same place or whether they came from different places, and it really doesn't matter. It was in that city that they saw the star. They saw the spark of light. It got them excited. It got them interested. And they began to say, we want to see where this star is going to take us. Where are we going to journey with it? And so we can reflect upon our lives, and there is perhaps an unnamed city, an unnamed event, an unnamed situation where we too receive that spark, receive that light of the Lord. And it got us thinking about our relationship with Jesus Christ. It got us thinking that we want to do a little bit more. We want to frequent the sacraments. We want to read the scripture. We want to pray more. We want to do some spiritual reading. We really want to deepen our relationship with Jesus Christ. And so we can reflect upon that unnamed city, unnamed situation, unnamed event that changed our lives, that began that journey to move us to know more about Jesus Christ. Our second city is the city of Jerusalem. Because today, the wise men showed up, come to Herod and said, we've seen the star, show us the newborn king of Israel, and we want to be able to worship him. And it said that King Herod and all of Jerusalem was troubled. Well, first of all, they shouldn't have been troubled because they were a major city. They had constantly seen a number of people who had come in because it was a source of commerce. People were coming to do business. People were coming to see the king. People were coming to worship in the temple. So there would have been a number of people that came in there, but something was different about these three persons. Because they came over field and fountain, moor and mountain, following that yonder star. Oh, yeah, I saw something. And it's brought me here. And I need to find out more about it. So at times we have our city of Jerusalem. We are the ones that were not so excited. We didn't journey over field and fountain, moor and mountain. We didn't see that bright light. And maybe the sacraments don't mean too much to anymore. Our prayer life has gone sour. We're not excited about having that relationship with the Lord. We haven't seen the spark. We're not aware of how the Lord speaks to us in our daily lives. And so we don't have a movement, and it's like, okay, you go find them, and when you find them, let us know. Or we might be the people who get excited because someone has come into our life, like those three persons, and they're energized, and they're moved, and they're spiritually filled, and they challenge us, and we begin to think, well, maybe I should follow them to the new city. Maybe I should follow them in many ways. Maybe I should return back to the sacraments. Maybe I should pray more. Maybe I should strengthen that relationship with the Lord. Maybe I create a New Year's resolution where I'm going to return back in a more spiritual nature in my journey with the Lord. And so in that Jerusalem, we are inspired in many ways. Our third city is the city of Bethlehem. Now, one of the things I find interesting in the Gospel of Matthew is there we don't get all the excitement about the city of Bethlehem that we've been talking about during the Christmas season. Because if you read the story of the birth of Jesus in the Gospel of Matthew, Joseph gets a dream. Take Mary into your life. So it says he goes and takes Mary as his wife. He doesn't have relationships with her. And when the child is born, he names him Jesus. Ta-dum, dam, that's it, we're done. And then you have the next story of today. After the child was born in Bethlehem, then the wise men came. But we know the rest of the story of Bethlehem. Jesus was the central point. He was born, the Son of God, born as human being. And he brought Mary, he brought Joseph, he brought the angels, he brought the shepherds, he brought the three wise persons. Maybe he brought the innkeeper, maybe there was the stable manager. I don't know who all was there, but they all came because this something was happening. Mary and Joseph pondered. The angels told their story to the shepherds, who told their stories to others. The wise men told their story, offered their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So in the story of Bethlehem, it was where they all congregated, but now they all left and returned to do their sharing of the story. Now there's another story of the wise men that said when they started to leave Bethlehem, they again saw the star, but they all saw the star leading in different directions, and they couldn't agree on what direction that was to be. So they said, well, they're all going to follow their own star. And it turned out that many weeks later, they returned back to the same place that they started from at the same time, even though they followed different paths. So we are the ones who tell our story. We ponder like Mary and Joseph. We tell the story like the shepherds did. We will go on our different journeys in telling our stories to others. But the key is we tell the story. We tell the story that we are now the body and blood of Christ. We have heard the word of God. Our life has changed because of the birth of Jesus Christ. And he has affected us and continues to affect us and continues to be a part of our life so that we now go out and tell the story. So we now go out over the field and fountain and moor and mountain and saying, oh yeah, there's that star. There's that thing that's lighting us. It's the ones that's giving us the energy we need to go and share that story. Because if we do that, then we're going to be the people going to those others in Jerusalem. We're going to go to those other places. We're going to be that enlightenment. We're going to be that epiphany. We're going to be that star. We're going to be that person that says, come and follow Jesus Christ and get to know him in your life. And if we can do that, then truly we will have an epiphany in our lives, but also be epiphany in the world, epiphany in our society, because all of us are going to come and recognize the person of Jesus Christ working in our daily lives. Let us stand together now and share our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As heirs of salvation, we have confidence to approach God with the needs of our world.
For the church, that we may be a light to those who are searching for direction and show the path toward life through our words and deeds of compassion and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's blessing in the new year, that God will fill the coming days with health of body, mind, and spirit, renew the gifts of the Spirit within us, and inspire us with new ways to show God's mercy to others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater trust, that like the wise men, God's light may guide us into the uncharted future, and that we may follow trusting in God's love and care for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater unity and cooperation within the human family, that God will heal the wounds of racial bias, open hearts to the talents of every person, and help us work together against violence, drug abuse, and poverty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all recovering from fires, cold weather, or blizzards, that God will guide them through the challenges that they face, renew their spirits, and open the hearts of many to assist and encourage them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of peace, that all hearts may strive to reject violence and yearn to follow in the ways of the Prince of Peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we pray the intentions of this Mass, let us remember Carl and Joyce Sismarick, for whom this liturgy is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of glory, we place these prayers in your hands, trusting that you will grant the people of our world what they most need, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please join me in the song for the preparation of the gifts, Away in a Manger, number 309.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ, as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, Holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope and George our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Paul and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us turn and offer to each other a sign of peace. Peace of Christ with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Blood of Christ. The blood of Christ.
What child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him laud, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold, and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to own him, the King. Loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Once upon a time, in a far-off land, wise men saw a sign and set out across the sand. Songs of praise to sing, they traveled day and night, precious gifts to bring. They were guided by the light. They chased a brand new star, ever towards the west, across the mountains far, but when it came to rest, they scarce believed their eyes. They'd come so many miles. The miracle they prized was nothing but a child. Nothing but a child could wash those tears away or guide the weary world into the light of day. Nothing but a child could help erase those miles, so once again we all can be children for a while. Now all around the world, in every little town, every day is heard a precious little sound. Every mother kind, every father proud, looks down in awe to find another chance allowed. Nothing but a child could wash those tears away or guide the weary world into the light of day. Nothing but a child could help erase those miles, so once again we all can be children for a while. Nothing but a little baby, nothing but a little baby, nothing but a child.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I want to again thank all of you for joining us, our reader, our musicians, our technicians, and those over the Ecumenical Channel joining us here today on this Feast of Epiphany. Thank you for coming out of the cold, and please drive carefully on your way home. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who has called you out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon you and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity. Amen.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters. Amen. Amen. And so when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord. Amen. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in Go Tell It on the Mountain, number 205.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching, or silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain.